Hi guys, I'm back with a new video, and this video is about entities that are bound to a specific place or stuck in a certain behavior pattern that they showed before they died. I already did a few videos about Johanna, a young girl that was trapped under her graveyard stone because she had no idea how to move and had no idea that she could move. I had to train her and teach her by using offering stones, and she's fine now. She is all over the place and having fun, and that's very important. And she's happy, I'm happy for her, so we are fine. In an earlier video, I did a video on a 6-7-year-old boy that was bound to my parents' hallway behind the front door, and he was able to think himself through the wall and back, but still he was bound to that specific place. A new example is I do groceries on my bike, and about 20 years ago there was a very busy road, and on one side there were apartment buildings, and on the other side there was a shopping center and his grocery store. This man always suddenly popped up at this side of the road and then waited for the right time to cross the road, and then on the other side of the road he suddenly disappeared. At first I thought I have to be aware of my environment because I bump into this man every day, and at some point I probably won't be able to stop. And it took me a long time to realize that this man was dead, and very dead. And at some point I decided to talk to him because I thought, well, if I can see him, maybe other people can see him too, and this might end up in a horrible traffic accident at some point. So I asked him what he was doing, and he said, well, my wife is living in the apartment building over there, and I am doing groceries for her, for us, every day, so it's my job to do the groceries. And I should have be more considerate and more gentle and respectful, but I said, you're dead. You're so dead. And he looked at me and then he disappeared. So maybe he needed some kind of shock moment to vanish, dissolve, solve this problem. And I never saw him again. Behind these apartment buildings, there is a huge area with forests and streams and fields. And in certain field, around a certain field, there was a little red riding hood. A little girl with blonde hair in plaits, and a grandmother. And every time I was on the other side of the field, I wanted to help them by opening the gate. But every time I opened the gate, they suddenly disappeared. Completely gone. So I knew this grandmother and the little girl were walking behind me, and by crossing the field, the distance between us became bigger, and as soon as I opened the gate, they were gone. Every time I walked there, this happened. So I just thought, well, they're fine, fresh air, they're together, they can enjoy each other's company, so just leave it. In my attic upstairs lives a grandfather and an old man and his little boy, grandson. And the first time I tried to enter the attic, they almost threw me down the stairs. But we came to a certain agreement. I keep the attic nice and tidy, my altar is there, and grandmother and the little boy and I are fine and everything is okay. I made them a special place, so they have a television and a little couch and some other stuff, so it's fine. In my closet, in my bedroom, there lives an old lady, the grandmother. Grandfather is on the attic, grandmother is in my closet. And to Reiki, other Reiki masters once visited my home, and the guy said that I should put a white table in the corner with some flowers and some incense and some candles to send grandmother to the light. I don't know, but most entities I see and communicate with have no interest aren't at all interested in going to the light. I think there's nothing there for them except light. So it's kind of boring, I think. I don't know if the light is the same as Christian people think about heaven, but I don't think heaven is the place to be when you're dead. It's boring, empty, I don't know. Maybe just before you are going through rebirth, it's a good place to be, but if you're not ready, then you're not ready, and then you're just doing things that you are used to doing when you are still alive. And I think these are a few fun examples, and of course there are loads of other examples, but these are pretty cool, I think. So that's it, and see you next time. Bye.